Welcome to our Maundy Thursday portion of Holy Week worship at Westminster. We invite you to join us tomorrow night at 7 o'clock as our worship continues with Good Friday and to our Easter celebration at 11 o'clock on Sunday morning. In the Gospel of John, Jesus says, "I give you a new commandment that you should love one another. Just as I have loved you, you also should love one another. Beloved people of God, this is the night when Christ, our Passover lamb, surrendered himself to those who would kill him, setting us free from sin and death forever. This is the night when Christ, our teacher and Lord, knelt down to wash the disciples' feet, showing us how to love and serve one another. This is the night when Christ, the bread of heaven, shared a holy meal with his followers, offering a feast of abundant life and grace for all. This is the night when Christ is betrayed."
Join me in the call to worship. This Lent, we have journeyed to many tables, interrupted tables, testing tables, overturned tables, forgiving tables. Tonight we gather at the most important table of all, the communion table. We come to taste the bread of life, even in the face of death. We come to remember the story of Jesus and our place in it. Come to this table of grace, this borrowed Passover table, and be filled with God's goodness. Bow your heads for the prayer of adoration. O God, your love is embodied in Jesus Christ, who washed disciples' feet at the night of his betrayal. Wash us from the stain of sin, so that in hours of danger we may not fail, but follow your Son through every trial and praise him always as Lord in Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. How is it that people will recognize us as followers of Jesus? Simply by how we treat one another. Let us confess how we have not loved as Christ loves us, praying together. Creator and loving God, you kneel to wash our feet, yet we are reluctant for you to see the places we have gone in our attempts to escape you. You would bathe us in the warm, living waters of your love, even though we splash and play in the puddles of temptation. We have received all the gifts you have to offer, yet we are tempted to think they are only for us rather than sharing them. Forgive us, Holy One, and have mercy on us. What can we give you for all your wonderful graciousness towards us? As you have broken your heart for us, may we open ours in service to others. As you have given your life for us, may we offer ours to bring healing to the world. As you have called us together around your table, may we go forth to feed a world hungry, not only for food, but for that spirit which brings peace and reconciliation. This we pray as servants of Jesus Christ, who came to serve us in life, in death, in resurrection hope. And we all say, Amen.
This night, we are reminded that we are forgiven. In these waters, we are named and claimed as God's beloved children. Join me in our assurance of pardon. God comes to give us living water to thirsty people. God comes to anoint us with the grace that wipes away our sin. God comes to fill us with joy. Our tears are turned into rivers of grace. Our weeping becomes glad cries of praise. I declare to you in the name of Jesus Christ, our sins are forgiven. Amen.
The prayer for illumination. Since we do not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from your mouth, make us hunger for this heavenly food, that it may nourish us today in the ways of eternal life through Jesus Christ, the bread of heaven. Amen. Our Old Testament this evening is from Exodus chapter 12, verses 1 through 4 and 11 through 14. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month shall mark you for you the beginning of months. It shall be the first month of the year for you. Tell the congregation of Israel that on the 10th of this month, they are to take a lamb for each family, a lamb for each household. If a household is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join its closest neighbor in attaining one. The lamb shall be divided in proportion to the number of people who eat of it. This is how you shall eat it: your loins girded, your sandals on your feet, and your staff in your hand, and you shall eat it hurriedly. It is the Passover of the Lord. For I will pass through the land of Egypt that night, and I will strike down every firstborn in the land of Egypt, both human beings and animals. On all the gods of Egypt I will execute judgments. I am the Lord. The blood shall be a sign for you on the houses where you live. When I see the blood, I will pass over you, and no plague shall destroy you when I strike the land of Egypt. This day shall be a day of remembrance for you. You shall celebrate it as a festival to the Lord. Throughout your generations, you shall observe it as a perpetual ordinance." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Our psalm reading this evening is from Psalm 116, verses 1 and 2, 12 through 19. I love the Lord, because the Lord has heard my voice and my supplications, because he inclined his ear to me. Therefore I will call on the Lord as long as I live. What shall I return to the Lord for all his bounty to me? I will lift up the cup of salvation and call on the name of the Lord. I will pay my vows to the Lord in the presence of all his people. Precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his faithful ones. O Lord, I am your servant. I am your servant, the child of your serving girl. You have loosed my bonds. I will offer to you a thanksgiving sacrifice and call on the name of the Lord. I will pay my vows to the Lord in the presence of all his people, in the courts of the house of the Lord, in your midst, O Jerusalem. Praise the Lord. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The gospel reading from Luke 22, verses 7 through 23. Listen to this. Then came the day of unleavened bread, on which the Passover lamb had to be sacrificed. So Jesus sent Peter and John, saying, "Go and prepare the Passover meal for us, that we may eat it." They asked him, "Where do you want us to make preparations for it?" "Listen," he said to them, "when you have entered the city, a man carrying a jar of water will meet you. Follow him into the house he enters and say to the owner of the house, 'The teacher asks you, where is the guest room? Where may I eat the Passover with my disciples?' He will show you a large room upstairs, already furnished. Make preparations for us there." So they went and found everything as he had told them, and they prepared the Passover meal. When the hour came, Jesus took his place at the table, and the apostles with him. He said to them, "I have eagerly desired to eat the Passover with you before I suffer, for I tell you, I will not eat it until it is fulfilled in the kingdom of God." Then he took a cup, and after giving thanks, he said, Take this and divide it among yourselves. For I tell you that from now on I will not drink of the fruit of the vine until the kingdom of God comes. Then he took a loaf of bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to them, saying, "This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And he did the same with a cup after supper, saying, "This cup that is poured out for you is the new covenant in my blood. But see, the one who betrays me is with me, and his hand is on the table. For the Son of Man is going as it has been determined, but woe to that one by whom he is betrayed." Then they began to ask one another which one of them it could be who could do this. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Like his entrance into Jerusalem on Palm Sunday, Jesus has a plan tonight. Jesus has it figured out how they will celebrate the Passover meal in Jerusalem. Like the search for the donkey, he sends his disciples ahead of him to acquire an upper room for them to dine together. A borrowed donkey, a borrowed table. It's a good reminder that Jesus did not have enough to call his own. And yet, as Lord of all creation, he always had what he needed. And at the borrowed table, he once more transforms from guest to host of this Passover meal. Our table tonight is set up for our Christian communion, but also as a reflection of the Jewish Seder dinner, which they shared every year at Passover time. The Passover meal is a dinner of redemption, designed to invite the faithful to remember their ancestors, remember their delivery from slavery in Egypt. As they eat bitter foods of affliction like horseradish, it brings the Exodus to life. They move from slavery to freedom, from bitter herbs to a delicious feast. In college, my friend Liz invited me to the Seder dinner with Hillel, the Jewish student organization. It was my first Jewish Seder and a fantastic experience. I watched in awe as they traced the story of the Hebrews being set free, traveling through the parted Red Sea. Everything at the table and on the plates had meaning. And when we were finished with the liturgy, we ate a fabulous meal together. Ever the attentive religious studies major, I paid close attention to the ritual. One thing that struck me was the way they talked about the deliverance of their ancestors. They never said, "and then they were free." Everything was "we." Remember when we were slaves in Egypt? Remember when we were delivered by God? You see, in the Passover Seder, to remember is not just to think about things in the past, but to re-engage them in the present. To remember is to remember, to put it all back together again. Jesus engages with this tradition as he sits at the borrowed table and says, "Do this in remembrance of me." As Presbyterians, we believe that something happens at this borrowed table, something beyond simply remembering past events. We believe that somehow in the mystery of faith, Christ himself is here with us. As the pastor, Reverend Judith Jones, puts it, remembrance is not simply the memory of the distant past. It connects the past with the present and the future, where the living Christ continues to be among his followers, still giving himself for them. It is not just the disciples who sit at a borrowed table tonight. We too sit at a borrowed table. It is not just the disciples who break bread and drink the cups with our Lord Jesus Christ. We too dine at the table with Jesus. It is not just Judas who betrays Jesus this night. It is we who betray Judas with what we have done and what we have left undone. It is not just me in this space by myself tonight. We, as the body of Christ in homes all over the world, share in this meal together. At this table, they becomes we, as our stories intertwine together, as we move again from slavery to sin to freedom in Christ, from despair to hope, from betrayal to forgiveness. This table tonight is a borrowed table, for it's not my table or yours. It's not a Presbyterian table or a Texan table. It is the Lord's table. No matter where we are tonight, we sit at our borrowed tables, knowing our Lord Jesus Christ is the ultimate host. Our borrowed table is good news, for it means Jesus reigns supreme, that Jesus is in charge, and that he welcomes even those who betray him to this meal. The phrase that ends every Passover Seder is, "Next year in Jerusalem," completing the movement from revisiting the past to looking forward to the future, dreaming of peace. Next year in the sanctuary, I say. Next year together. So may you find your spot at this borrowed table. May you remember Jesus' gift of his body and blood in a new covenant. A covenant that binds us together. A covenant that calls us to offer our witness and gifts. May you remember Jesus and know his presence tonight at this table. Amen.
I see the stars.
Now is the time to gather your communion elements at home and set them before you. You can pause the video if you need it. But now the parade is past, the hosannas have hushed, and Jesus has retreated to this upper room to dine quietly with his disciples. We are invited to this table to share in the mystery of broken bread, of a cup, and of feet humbly washed, challenging us to eat, drink, and remember together, and to love and serve one another as Jesus loves and serves us. We are invited to the table to see Judas get up from his seat and walk out the door, challenging us to look into our hearts and glimpse the signs of our own acts of betrayal. So let's take our place at this table, where we sense our brokenness and experience God's grace all at once. You are welcome. May the God of Last Suppers be with you, and also with you. Open your hearts to God this night. We open them to the one whose heart is broken this night. In the midst of uncertainty and fears, we will praise God. Our thanks are offered to the one who walks and waits with us through long nights. When the hour had come, Creator of the heavens and earth, you lifted up the cup of creation, pouring it into the emptiness of chaos. Rivers played tag through the valleys. Joy danced in the fields of grace. Given that fountain flowing with living water, we drank from betrayal's bitter cup. You asked us, the prophets, to remind us of promises made, but we continued to embrace the pangs of hopelessness. Then, because we are your own, you sent Jesus to glorify you by saving us from ourselves. Therefore, with those whose feet are covered with sin and those whose hearts are gripped by fear, we join the choirs of every time and place, forever singing your praises. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy are you, God of redemption, and blessed is Jesus Christ, our servant, our Savior. When the hour had come, he got up from grace's side, took off his glory, tied humanity around his heart to cleanse us of our sins. Our friend, he welcomed all. Our teacher, he modeled the life of obedience and faith. Our redeemer, he endured the snares of death, that we might have life with you. Every time we eat the bread, our brokenness is made whole. Every time we drink from the cup, we receive unceasing grace. Every time we come to the table, we remember that mystery called faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Now that the hour is come, send your spirit upon the gifts of the bread and the cup. As you cradle the bread in your gentleness, break it, give it to us, feed us with your compassion that we might be made whole and in our healing become servants to a shattered world. As you take the cup, mingle its juices with your tears of hope so we might carry this gift to all who have lost everything. And when there are no more hours to come, when there is only eternal peace and life with you, we will gather in that upper room called your heart, serving our families and friends with grace, receiving forgiveness from our enemies, singing your joy forever and ever, God and community holy in one, continuing to pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. The Lord Jesus, on the night of his arrest, took bread, And after giving thanks to God, he broke it and said, "This is my body given for you." On the same night, in the same manner, he took the cup and said, "This is the cup of the new covenant shed in my blood for the forgiveness of sins." Every time we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the resurrection of the Lord and look for him to come again as we do this in remembrance of him. These are the gifts of God for the people of God. I invite you now to take your bread, to break off a piece, and to taste and see that the Lord is good. This is the body of Christ given for you. And now I invite you to take your cup and know that this cup was shed in Jesus' blood for you. Now I invite you to join me in our prayer after communion. God of grace, we give you thanks for the feast of redemption we have shared in the body and blood of our Savior. As you have nourished us with love, let our lives proclaim your great love for the world through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Jesus walked on this earth so many years ago. He practiced a ministry of radical inclusivity, drawing to himself all the despised and rejected members of society. He lived what he taught, a life of justice and love, of profound compassion for all people. He lived a life acceptable to you, O God.
Tonight we remember the betrayal of our Lord Jesus Christ by Judas and by us, when we ignore his commands to love one another, to feed the hungry, to care for the poor, to welcome strangers to the table, we too betray him once more. We too are part of the crowd who condemns him to suffer.
As we extinguish this light, we acknowledge the darkness and pain of all the children in the world who suffer in body, in mind, or in spirit.
Let us pray together. What we contemplate this night is beyond words, beyond understanding. May the Holy Spirit intercede for us and give voice to what for us is inexpressible. Amen. My God, why have you forsaken me? Why are you so far from helping me from the words of my groaning? Oh my God, I cry by day, but you do not answer, and by night, but find no rest.